Have you ever wondered how to divide a quadrilateral into a certain number of even pieces? I'm going to be showing you how to do this today. See, here I've created a quadrilateral. There's nothing really special about it. This method will even work if the quadrilateral is concave. So now I'm going to create a diagonal, one of the two diagonals of the quadrilateral. What we have to do is divide this diagonal into the number of divisions that you want of the quadrilateral. So for example, if you want to divide this quadrilateral into two even pieces, you would divide this segment into two equal parts. If you want to divide this quadrilateral into five equal parts, then you would divide this segment into five equal parts. Just for demonstration purposes, I'm going to be dividing this quadrilateral into four equal parts. And here's something, if you're dividing the quadrilateral into a number of parts, and that number of parts is power of two, then you can get away with using midpoints to divide this segment right here. So I'm going to create the midpoint of that segment. And then just divide, and just bisect the new parts again. So now I've divided this diagonal here into four equal parts. Now what this does here is create eight triangles in this quadrilateral. And so I'm going to show you here. If we take three of the original vertices of the quadrilateral, clicked the wrong command. Three of the original vertices of the quadrilateral, but then create an area that uses this first point here instead of this point over here. You'll find that the area of this piece right here is a quarter of that of the entire quadrilateral. If you do the math, you'll find that 3.73 is about a quarter of 14.92. Oh no, maybe it's exact. And now, if I'll just create these other four pieces. Excuse me here. And then find their areas. You can see they're all 3.73 square units. So, you can see this quadrilateral has been divided into four equal parts. Now, if you wanted to divide it into five parts, for example, then you would have simply divided this diagonal here into five equal parts and then created the mini quadrilaterals there. Yeah. And as I said earlier, this will work even if the quadrilateral is concave. So if I just turn this into a concave quadrilateral, you can see these areas are still the area of the entire quadrilateral. Now do note that if your quadrilateral is concave, you can only use one of the diagonals. I mean, obviously in this case, if you tried to use the diagonal out here, you wouldn't be able to divide the quadrilateral very well. So that's all it takes, and that's all for today.